first one gone. And we'd be stuck here, left in this miserable world. So the devil knows what he gave up. So now it's an opportunity for us to give it back. But you have to surrender yourself. You have to be humble. Sometimes restoration comes after you've been torn down. You have to be stripped of all of that muck and that mire in order for God to bring out what you need. And this is a wonderful testimony that rings in my mind so much every time I think about it and how God can bring you out of something that you don't mind me saying. Sister Bernadette Addison, when she came out of her addiction, the one thing she said, this thing rang so true to me, is when she said she got down, she fell down, and she said, "Lord, if you just clean me up, if you just deliver me out of this, Lord God, I will be the faithful servant." And I've never forgotten that. And when I seen her testify to that, there was so much conviction and passion in her eye that I just never forget it. And always, that's the kind of surrender that God wants us to have. He wants us to be that helpless little child so that he can carry us when the time is right. He will walk with us when we need, when we only need a friend to walk with, but when the thing gets thick, we can know we can lean on Jesus. That's why he left us with the Holy Ghost. So it shouldn't be a battle. It is a battle between the flesh and the Holy Ghost, but it shouldn't be a battle. We should tell that flesh to be still and let this Holy Ghost work the way it's supposed to work. Let this Holy Ghost guide me now as opposed to guide me. Let this Holy Ghost help me to speak to every single situation that's in front of me, because I know God can deliver. Those chains are broken, and I don't need to be put back in bondage anymore. I don't want to go to bondage. You ask someone that's been incarcerated how quick they want to go back. It's the same thing when you come out of sin. Why do you want to go back to it? They liken it to a dog to turn into his vomit. Think about that. That's the lowest you can get. But God can deliver you out of every situation that you're in. Just lean on and give it to Jesus. You know, endure to the end. You know that God will deliver you out of everything if you believe Him. That's the key. None of this works if we don't believe Him. If we just come in here to be seen because we got a new outfit, we might as well close up shop now. We come here because we have faith and belief that everything in His Word is true and God is going to deliver us out. We have to repent. We have to receive the water of baptism. We speak in other tongues as the Spirit gives utterance, and God takes care of everything else. We don't have anything to worry about. Yes, it's going to be dark days. I'm not here to deceive you in any way. We all know that you're going to be facing some tests and trials. But the Lord will deliver you out of every situation. He did it for Israel, and He promised it to us. I always say, when you're thinking about when He took them to the Red Sea and to Jordan, if He brings you to it, He's going to bring you through. You don't have to worry about anything else. God will get you over to the Jordan. God will get you over to the other side. He's going to deliver you out. But I expect you to be faithful to me. And I'm going to give you the power to walk amongst these people of iniquity. I will give you the power to look at your adversary and rebuke that demon and rebuke that situation and lean on it. We have to do our part. We have to do our fasting. We have to do our praying. But most importantly, we have to be watchful always so that we can't be deceived. No one can distract us from anything that should draw us away from the Word of God. God is faithful and kind to us. God has been merciful to us. God has delivered us on a daily basis. He's allowed us. Some of us have been saved 30, 40 years. Me, myself, only been saved 7 years, but the Lord has blessed me in those 7 years. You know, I don't know what God would have me to do going forward. I take it one day at a time. I give Him my honor and His glory every single night and day before I lay out. The last words out of my mouth is, "Thank you, Jesus. I made it through the day. Thank you, Jesus. I made it through the night. Lord, go out before me today so that I can face my enemies head on. Keep your arm of protection around me, not only me, but my family, my friends. Keep us all protected. We don't know how many unseen dangers we face on a daily basis. When I travel to work at night, as soon as I get to the destination, I say, "Thank you, Lord." Because I don't know what it's going to be. I want to just make sure I please God. I want to please nobody else. Like I said, if I get friends along the way, amen. But it's all about pleasing God. Paul didn't care. Paul didn't worry about who he offended when it came to the Word of God. I'm going to deliver what God would have me to do. Jesus, as a little boy, what did he say? "I must be about my Father's business." That's how we got to be. We got to be you're going to be an usher, be the best usher. Be an usher unto God. You know, if you're going to be a musician unto God. Take everything that God gives you and apply it to pleasing Him. He takes care of everything else. There's been plenty of times I've gotten up here, no, I messed up a song. And all they got to say, I don't know if y'all were being nice or not, but only thing I heard was, well, you did a good job on that song. Thank you, Jesus, for that. You covered it up. You covered whatever the mistake was up. See, God will take care of you. You don't even realize it. So when we recognize that the Lord has done something for us, that's even more of a blessing. He wants us to be blessed by Him. Don't look about the next man and what the next man got. Take what you got and take care of it to the best of your ability, because God will give it to you for you. It wasn't for anybody else. We can't be looking down on people for whatever reason because we think we've arrived. Because how quickly can God tear you down? And be careful, because you might see the same people on your way down. You know, so make sure. Be kind. The Bible teaches about it in Corinthians all the time. Charity. That's love. If we love one another like the Lord says love, there would be no wars and rumors of war. Because we wouldn't have time. I don't know about you, but I love myself. So if I'm not going to hurt myself, why would I hurt my brother or my sister? You know, if we took care of that and just minded and took care of ourselves, God will take care of everything else. Put this world would be a beautiful place to be in. But people have given up. People don't fear God anymore. It's a shame. It's a shame. People do not fear the Lord anymore. That's why they continue to do the things that they do. And then when things don't work out your way, you want to blame God. You want to run away. I'm not doing it no more. Well, what did you do when He was blessing you? Think about that. When I'm faced with adversity, the first thing I say is, Lord, am I outside of your will? You know, if I can't find a fault in myself, then I still smile and say, because I know it has to happen. God's going to take me to a next level. It's just like running over hurdles. When you jump, if you make that first one, you feel good about the next one. And if you make that one, you feel good about the next one. Let's look at our tests and our trials the same way. When you get through one, you strengthen for the next one. It might be a little taller, but you're ready to go forward. God can deliver you out of anything. Think about it. Enjoy in the deliverance that God has for you. It's all in His works. Everything that we're going to face again, don't you think He already knows? God has already said, I'm working out for you if you believe in me. How else can He get you to believe in Him if He doesn't do things and show you? But when Peter walked on the water, what happened? He took his eyes off. He began to sink. So we just got to keep our eyes on Jesus. Don't worry about everything that's in the way. Straight and narrow is the way. But we know what's at the end. If we believe the Word, we know what's at the end. But it's going to be trouble if you be left behind. You don't want to be left behind. Those five foolish virgins, but they said, give us your all. Well, what would I give up my blessing for? I'm not going to give up my blessing for you because you didn't take the time to prepare. You haven't prepared. I can't talk to no one into heaven. I can't pray no one into heaven, because when they will us down that aisle in that box, we by ourselves. So we're going to stand in judgment by ourselves. So just make sure whatever your last chapter of your life is that is written in the book of life, that Jesus was able to say, they did well. They did well. So on the day of judgment, you can rise up with the church. And all that stuff that you thought, or people thought you missed out on by going to church and not doing this, you will have the last laugh. But it won't even matter, because once we're with Jesus, it's going to be all good. It's all good at that point. That's what we strive for. We're looking for deliverance. When I'm in my fire, I want God in there with me. When I'm in the line of the day, I want the Lord in there with me. Wherever I go, I want Jesus in there with me. Even when I'm in the same home, sometimes I just find myself saying, thank you, Lord. You know, it's just in me like breathing now, because I know what God has done for me. I remember when I first moved into my house, I wasn't saved yet, and I was standing on the back of the moving truck, and something just came over me. I broke down and I started crying. And I just said, thank you, Jesus. You know, it might have been a material feel-good moment, but that started me on my path, and I didn't realize that I'm acknowledging what God was trying to do for me, bring me to, and show me what I can be done. So I just want to encourage you today to follow after Jesus no matter what. Don't worry about the fiery darts. They're going to come. He didn't tell us that they weren't going to happen. It's not a secret that they're going to happen. Everyone that walked with Jesus faced some type of adversity. So why shouldn't we? Jesus took on the ultimate sacrifice. Look at the adversity that he had faced. And he didn't ask us to do that. He just asked us to take care of yourself by following after my commandments and my love. Amen? That's all. That's what the Lord wants us to do. Stay focused on Him. We get so many times we get distracted on this thing, the other thing in the world, and you know we hear it all the time. Oh, I'm tired. I don't feel like. Oh. But you gotta press through. You have to press on for the Lord, because the Lord looks at that. Says they still love Him. They still got love. And they're doing it. And just when you think you're gonna give up, you get that little ounce more strength and energy to go forward. And God will deliver you out of it. I can't say it enough, because it says it right here in verse 13.